Showdowns. Supergirl started off with the right hand, much to the delight of the fans here in Thailand for their native daughter.
Yeah, she timed that right hand right off of Lara Fernandez's inside leg kick right there. As soon as Lara fired, did it right there. Lara threw the rear leg, and Supergirl stepped in with the cross of her own.
Fernandez has a very wide guard, and it's dangerous with a puncher right. Supergirl, who comes right down the middle with that, those straight shots. Lara's got to tighten that defense up, get that head movement.
Lara Fernandez 7-3 in her last three fights. Supergirl's claiming that I'm only going to focus on kickboxing from here on out.
You see Supergirl really firing those feints in the way that she was talking about this week, trying to get Lara Fernandez to commit.
Supergirl said she's working on going in and out, adding more fakes, and to add pressure. Good left hook that connected for the 19-year-old Thai sensation. Spinning back kick that missed for Fernandez. Coming up on the midway point of the first.
I like Laura's strategy here. Her frame is a little wide, like Mitch mentioned before. But also, when she's throwing these kicks, she has to, as quickly as she throws that kick out, she's got to get it back on the ground because she has too much recovery time. And Supergirl has the ability to capitalize on that.
Fernandez hasn't been able to dodge that right hand, Mitch.
Yeah, she's having a hard time with it. Supergirl's coming right over the top of her lead hand and touching her on the chin over and over again. Fernandez needs to speed things up here a little bit, pick up the pace, maybe shift gears and start to put a little more pressure on Supergirl. Supergirl's finding her rhythm. That's what she needs to do. Fernandez needs to go forward.
It's not the pace of the punches as much, Mitch. Like, it's the speed of each punch that she's throwing.
Speed means pace, bro.
Yeah. Go.
You can be liberal with that definition if you like.
Under a minute left in our first stanza.
It's like you said, it's the recovery. She's leaving things out there a little bit too long. Like she's leaving her hands out there, her legs out there. She's not resetting quick enough to fire again.
Absolutely, and that's giving Supergirl the time to capitalize on these things with the counters.
Good right hand for Supergirl as near the end of the first.
That's it, good.
A knee right to the abdomen of Fernandez.
Yeah, that's one of Supergirl's best weapons.
So we are here, round number two in Lapini Boxing Stadium, the pinnacle of martial arts, where you see the best on a consistent basis with one championship, the world's leading martial arts organization. Supergirl in the second round against Lara Fernandez.
Supergirl's got to be careful on those clinches. She has a tendency to go right for that clinch work that she's so well known for.
And one of her best weapons in Muay Thai was that clinch, utilizing those knees. But now that she's transitioning to kickboxing, she has to make those adjustments. You can see she, after the hand combination, she kind of reaches up like she wants to grab the head.
Well, Supergirl, a nice right to the body. She has been fighting since she was a kid. She fought for $9. She was 10 years old.
See that spear knee that she followed up with off that right hand there Mitch was talking about, coming in just like a push kick.
Supergirl has looked terrific. She's very sharp right hand by Fernandez, though, catching the attention of the 19-year-old Thai sensation.
Yeah, Fernandez is doing her best work when she actually initiates the attack, not trying to counter off for Supergirl, but coming in with that initial jab. Right there, she's letting Supergirl set the pace. Supergirl countered off the right leg, but when she can get off those clean punches, she typically lands 2-3-piece combination. Right there, she eludes. This is how she needs to be doing this, is getting those feet back on the ground quickly so that she can be out of the way.
Supergirl has been hammering Fernandez, and man, she's got a chin on her, doesn't she?
Yeah, but she's getting tested, but you don't want that chin tested. You gotta start moving your head. She's getting touched over and over again with that right hand, and she cannot find an answer for it.
Oh, what a kick by Fernandez.
She been throwing that regularly, that high kick to Supergirl's left side. She's catching Supergirl with her hand down. The kicks of Fernandez are there, especially to the legs and the head.
Olivia Cost separates them. Boy, what a battle. I mean, literally the entire night we have seen just back and forth we go.
That's what happens here at Lupini, man. These fighters show up and put on their best performances. There's something about this atmosphere, this crowd, this building that really ignites our fighters.
Well, you know the icons that have fought here, and you're seeing a memorizing performance from Supergirl against Lara Fernandez.
Olivia Cost is warning Supergirl there on the clinch. 3 seconds, you have to work. And then you got to let go
more of that.
Yeah, that head kick came off of the cross that she threw. Supergirl slipped to the outside of that cross. She followed up using that cross basically as a setup for that kick.
Third and final round between Supergirl and Lara Fernandez. As Supergirl has shown the durability of her chin here against Fernandez at the iconic Lupinian Boxing Stadium. Something about this place where you see memorable performances.
Rich, talk to me about this clinch rule. You don't necessarily have to grab in a Thai plum, but if you put your hands on their shoulders, is that classified as a clinch?
I mean, I don't think so, but it could be because you're controlling your opponent. It didn't look to me like Supergirl was doing anything to control the opponent. Hands are out there. You're obviously touching each other, but it seemed to me that it wasn't a control thing. She was just following up with several knees. Olivier Cost was in on the action. He saw it as, you know, a warning to give her. It's like, hey, don't clinch and grab. I think it was more, from this perspective at least, that Lara Fernandez was stuck in that corner. Fernandez has done a better job in this round of at least tightening this guard up, so it's a little bit more difficult for Supergirl to get things going through the middle.
Good right to the body by Supergirl as Fernandez continues to come forward. Supergirl very sharp tonight. She's being tested by the 27-year-old from Spain in Lara Fernandez.
Lara's doing a good job in this round. She's picked the pace up, landing a lot of kicks, pushing forward, taking less damage. Supergirl's not landing as many counters.
Supergirl has slowed down in this third round, but she might be up 2-0. So she might just be able to, you know, take this round off and still get the W. But Lara's got to really start to turn things up. Find some, capitalize on this success that she's finding and start to push this pace.
She said she is calm and ready to go, and she's not going away against Supergirl as we are under a minute to go in the fight.
Yeah, Lara Fernandez spends a lot of time on her strength and conditioning program, so you know she is coming in here in top shape. Good push kick and then a hook to the body.
Yeah, the volume that she's throwing with these kicks in this round is truly something amazing because, you know, the first two rounds of this match were a fairly high pace, and you can see that Supergirl here is a bit worn out. She doesn't have the snap on the punches and kicks that she had in the first two rounds, and Lara has done exactly what she said that she's going to do, is wear Supergirl down. The question is it too little too late?
Well, Lara Fernandez dreamed about being a dancer. She wasn't doing too much dancing, but Supergirl, clearly the more technically brilliant fighter as we head towards the battle.